Hi guys, I'm Tom Booton, and today we're in the iconic Dorchester Hotel at the Grill by Tom Booton, right in the middle of the kitchen. Today we're going to show you our banana and chocolate chip cookie recipe, which we have on our current breakfast menu. It's absolutely sweet and delicious, and it's perfect to take away after your full English. Just before we begin with all the recipes, please remember to subscribe and like. So to start off, we've got 150 grams of butter, nice and soft. And then inside that, we're going to add 80 grams of dark brown sugar and 80 grams of caster sugar. We're going to cream that all together until it comes lovely and fluffy. And then we'll do the next steps after that. So into the KitchenAid. And then start it off nice and slowly so it doesn't splash everywhere. And then we're going to leave that for about 3 to 4 minutes for it to all come together, the sugar really dissolve into the butter, and it goes light and fluffy. Okay, so as you can see, the butter and the sugar has really come together now, and it's starting to fluff. So this recipe will make about two to three cookies, so it's perfect for a Sunday morning. You can make the dough the night before and then just come in and bake them fresh in the morning. So we're going to crack an egg into a container, and then I'm just going to whisk that together with a fork just to bring it together. We will then add this into the mix, slow down the machine a touch, and then incorporate that. This will almost split the batter a little bit, and then we're going to bring it back with the flour. So now the egg's incorporated into the batter. Now we're going to add in 225 grams of normal plain flour and 1 gram of bicarbonate of soda. Bicarbonate of soda really helps the mixture kind of puff up and give it that nice oozy texture when it bakes. Go straight in. Inside of that as well, chocolate, banana, what you need is a little bit of salt. So a nice good pinch of molten sea salt. And then we're going to bring that together. Start it nice and slow so the flour doesn't go everywhere, and let it incorporate. So as you can see now, the flour is incorporated with the batter, and it's almost gone like a wet sandy kind of texture is what you're looking for. Inside that, just to make it super more indulgent, we're just gonna add a little bit more chocolate chips, just so when it bakes, it oozes into the cookie. Okay, that's ready to go. Turn off the machine, and it's as simple as that. So as I said before, this can be done the evening before, a couple of days in advance, and it can just sit in the fridge. You can also freeze the batter too. Just using the cling film, we're just gonna roll it into a log. So this is where you can make whatever size you want. If you wanna make little cookies, then you make a smaller log, but we're looking for a big, fat, nice one. Just get it into the shape you desire. So this is completely up to you. But obviously remember the different sizes you make, the different timings of temperature you need to look after as well. The bigger it is, the longer it will take to cook. The smaller it is, it will cook nice and fast. So I'm happy with that size. Using the cling film, roll it around, and then you're just going to roll it like a sausage really, give it a little spin, and that's beautiful and tight batter, ready to be baked once it's rested. So I'm going to pop this dough now into the fridge, let it rest for about an hour, but as I said before, this can be done well in advance, and then come back shortly and I'll show you how to cook it. Okay, so here we've got our rested dough. So I've cut these about 180 grams. This is the size we do in the restaurant. So we do it as a sharing kind of idea. After your full English, you can buy a big cookie, tear it in half, and kind of share it with your guests you're with. So it's 180 grams. I'm just gonna round it off ever so slightly, but I'm gonna place it in the oven at 165 degrees for 8 minutes. Once it comes out in 8 minutes, we're gonna reshape it with our mold, and then we're gonna add on our dolce and our banana caramel, which is the key to this banana and chocolate chip cookie. Okay, so it's going in the oven. Okay, so the cookies have just come out of the oven. They're about halfway cooked. Now we just want to reshape them. So as they cook, they kind of sag a little bit. So we're going to try and bring them back together, and then we're going to fill them with all of our bits and bobs. So just carefully using the ring of the size you want to use. Okay, so once you've got that desired size, we're then going to start filling it with our dolce, which is condensed milk, cooked down, beautiful and sweet. And then we've got the banana caramel, which is the secret. So we put the bananas in a really hot tray into the oven until they go nice and black. And then we make an intense caramel, really nice and dark, a little bit of rum. And then we add all the bananas into it and reduce it right down and then blitz it into a puree. So this can be free and easy as you wish. There's no right or wrong answer. This is where you can have a bit of fun with the cookies as well. It'd be great to do it with the kids, and you can make them smiley faces inside. So we've got two different types of chocolate here as well. We've got Tuma chocolate here from our good friend Richard at Terra Foods. Then we can finish it with a dolce on top, just to fill in the gaps. This is my favourite bit. Okay, Once they're all ready to go, we're going to put them back into the oven for 8 more minutes. Okay, so here we have it. So it's the wonderful chocolate chip cookie with the dolce caramel, the banana caramel, loads of chocolate. And remember, you can do whatever toppings you want. The dough is just a base of a recipe. You can add white chocolate on top, you can add even more chocolate, bits and bobs, whatever you want. The world's your oyster with it. For me, I'm just going to finish it with a bit more dolce because it's my favourite. And then I'm going to grate some white chocolate on top as well, and then it's ready to serve. So free and easy, just zigzag right on top. And then in here, we've just got some frozen white chocolate, which we caramelise white chocolate. So we bake it in the oven, and then we place it in the freezer. And then we just grate it from frozen on top, all over. Carefully remove the paper underneath. You can warm it back up in the oven if you like as well, but actually I quite like it room temp. Okay, so here you have it. You've got the banana and chocolate chip cookie. And this is for the most important bit, you have to try it. Look at that. Not bad at all. Oh, perfect weekend treat. Enjoy. If you love that recipe, we've got many more on our channel and we can't wait to share them all with you. Please subscribe.